Hello there, my fellow recruits and neophytes, and welcome back. Welcome back to another episode about the forces of the Space Marines. If you've been following my videos over the last week or so, you'd know that I did a video on the Space Marine Scouts recently. In fact, it was a very long overdue video. Thus, today, we are going to continue on exactly that same topic, aka the Scouts. Last time, we learned a few things about who they are, what they are, and how they do it. In this episode, we're mostly gonna focus on their equipment, and a couple of other tidbits. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? Though counter to the dictates of the Codex Astartes, a small number of chapters maintain training doctrines unique only to themselves. Some attach individual scout squads to specific battle or reserve companies on a permanent basis. The Black Templars chapter, for example, diverges from the standard doctrine, in that they do not use a specialized company to train their recruits. Rather, their neophytes are individually apprenticed to a fully-fledged battle brother. They fight alongside their mentors until deemed ready by him to progress to the rank of battle brother. Another notable exception to the practice is the Space Wolves, who place their successful neophytes together in units called Blood Claws. Space Wolves do use Scout Marines, but these are experienced veteran warriors, who prefer solitude to service in a pack and are known as Wolf Scouts. In this way, the Space Wolves maintain their own tradition, which are entirely at odds with the word of the Codex Astartes. The tactics utilized by Space Marine Scouts provide a very practical method of gaining experience in the ways of war. A Scout Marine must be fully versed in every conceivable aspect of war, even those he will never actually practice. Thus, scouts learn the arts of subterfuge, approaching the foe unseen, and striking before their presence is detected. Such tactics are rarely practiced by the reserve and battle companies, as the Codex Astartes dictates a very direct approach to warfare. As a Space Marine whose training is not yet complete, a scout doesn't have access to much of the more formidable weaponry that their more experienced battle brothers can utilize. The scouts, however, are issued all manner of specialized equipment. In many cases, these items are crafted by the chapter's tech marines for specific roles or missions, and enables the scout to carry out this mission with increased efficiency. Designated heavy weapon scouts can carry missile launchers or heavy bolters. Unlike tactical marines, however, scouts are equipped with heavy bolters with access to hellfire bolts, which are ideal for killing Tyranid bioforms. Scout sergeants usually carry bolt pistols and chainswords, but they can carry larger weapons, such as bolters or sniper rifles. However, sergeants are also given access to wargear like power weapons, plasma pistols, and even power fists in certain circumstances. Next, we're gonna learn a few things about the Scout Marine's panoply of war. Carbon titanium weave fatigues. A scout's fatigues are woven from a carbon titanium composite that is capable of defending against small arms fire. The cat's paw morphic tread combat boots. This is specialized footwear utilized by Space Marine scouts, enabling them to step quietly on all kinds of terrain, thus not giving away their position when operating behind enemy lines. The tight beam squad comlink. This is a specialized comlink worn by all the scouts, enabling them to transmit encrypted data to other members of the squad without the risk of enemy signals interception. The squad's leader has a long-range link, with which he can communicate with other units. The optical image enhancement array. Space Marine Scout snipers are issued with a powerful enhancement array for their sniper rifles, which is linked with their rifle's scope to allow them to literally see down the barrel of their gun. The Stalker Pattern Bolt Pistol. The bolt pistols utilized by the Space Wolf Scouts are a modified version of the common Godwin pattern in use by Astartes across the Imperium. Fitted with a suppressor unit to dampen its sound and muzzle flash, and an optical sight to augment a user's aim, the Stalker pattern bolt pistol is intended for the sort of operations performed by the Scouts. The Raven pattern shotgun. Raven Guard Scouts are among the best recon the Astartes have to offer, forging ahead of the chapter, identifying targets for quick strikes, and disrupting enemy logistics. For this reason, Raven Guards serving in the Jericho Reach Death Watch are commonly deployed to strike missions in the Canis Salient, using their stealth to operate behind enemy lines and strike high-value Tau targets. During a recent strike mission, shotgun fire gave away a scout's position and compromised the entire mission. In response, Deathwatch Forge Master Harl Greyweaver used an ancient technique incorporating flash and sound suppressors into the scout's weapon muzzle. This modification was met with such success that Greyweaver is willing to provide his time and skill to any Raven Guard who has proven himself worthy of the upgrade. The Astartes M40 A1 Pattern Sniper Rifle. The Codex Astartes states that a Space Marine must be schooled in every aspect of war, and this includes the use of a weapon that he may not necessarily go on to use as a fully-fledged battle brother. The sniper rifle is such a weapon, and its use fits the tactical role of the Scout. This rifle fires a small dart made from a deadly neurotoxin chemical. The liquid chemical is frozen into a dart or sliver within the gun before it is fired. Unerring accuracy is afforded by a low-power beam of invisible laser light, which drives and guides the chemical dart to its target. If the target is armored, the beam automatically pulses when the rifle is fired, punching a tiny hole, allowing the toxic dart to penetrate. And finally, the main attraction for today, the Scout Armor. Scout Armor, also sometimes referred to as Infiltrator Armor, is the standard type of combat armor worn by Space Marine Scouts before they become full initiates of their chapter and have earned the right to wear a true suit of power armor. Scout Armor is actually a modified suit of Imperial Carapace Armor, similar to that worn by elite members of the Imperial Guard, that has been enlarged to fit one of the Astartes. It is comprised of overlapping plates of ceramite, which can easily stop a kinetic round or a low-power directed energy bolt. The fabric fatigues, which cover the non-vital regions of the Scout's body, are composed of a type of ballistic nylon thread, which provides a lesser level of protection without reducing the Scout Marine's maneuverability. Scout armor is much more quiet and less cumbersome than true Astartes power armor, with all its mechanized and cogitator-aided systems. It is thus an ideal form of protection for the Scout Marines, who are responsible for undertaking their chapter's infiltration and sniper duties, where silence is paramount. The different built-in systems and abilities of Infiltrator armor are as follows. Please keep in mind that not all Scout armors are identical. For example, some of the things I'll mention are particular to the Death Watch. The Body Glove. The body glove worn under the Infiltrator's ceramite plates provides respectable armor protection, and does a decent job of protecting the wearer from hostile environments. It provides armored protection to the legs similar to that of power armor, and grants increased resistance to contact poisons, radiation, acid, or toxic chemicals. The Anointment of Obfuscation. The sacred unguents and special coating worked into the Scout Armor's hard plates and body glove make it incredibly difficult to detect via technological means. Anyone trying to detect a Space Marine wearing Infiltrator armor using autosenses, AuSpex, or Augur arrays finds that these technological systems have difficulty locking onto the target. The Scout's Vox. Each suit in the Deathwatch Scout armor carries a long-range, encrypted, multi-band Vox system, which allows the wearer to stay in contact with his unit. The transmitter is housed in the armor's back-mounted storage unit and is heavily insulated from shock and damage. The unit is voice-activated and is operated via a headpiece featuring a headphone-microphone combination. It also allows the wearer to communicate with other units as well as any Deathwatch armor or aerospace unit. It has a range of 35 kilometers, which can be stretched indefinitely with signal relays like other scouts or vehicle and power armored mounted VOX systems, and can transmit both voice and data. The Interlocutor Beacon. An infiltrator suit's interlocutor beacon helps identify the wearer as an ally to all friendly units he fights with. Broadcasting on a narrow band, highly encrypted frequency, with a range of 10 kilometers, the interlocutor beacon not only identifies the wearer as a space marine, but also acts as an emergency distress beacon. Every chapter has a unique frequency that all their beacons broadcast on, and this frequency is constantly changed by the chapter's tech marines in the interests of security. The Auto-Injector Cuff. Worn beneath one of the Deathwatch Scout Armor's Ceramite Gauntlets, this is a scaled-down version of the same item within standard Astartes Power Armor. It consists of a number of small vials and an auto-injector system run by a small cogitator array with a built-in biomonitor. Like the Power Armor unit, when the biomonitor detects a problem with the wearer's life signs, the cogitator immediately administers the proper drug to counteract whatever ails the space marine wearing it. It can provide some of the following benefits: a drug cocktail that can counteract most known toxins, poisons, and even the deleterious effects of ionizing radiation for a limited time. Two doses of pain-suppressing drugs that allow a space marine wearing the armor to ignore the effects of extreme wounds. The doses can be used in succession or staggered. If the wearer gets stunned, the Scout Armor's cogitator system will inject him with a series of stimulants which will negate the stun effects. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the Space Marine Scouts, and particularly their war gear, for today. Are the Scouts among your favorite forces in a Space Marine chapter? What do you like or dislike most about them? Feel free to share any thoughts, opinions, or experiences with the Scouts in the comments below. Also, even though I initially said it was gonna be two videos on them, it is probably gonna be three, as I do want to mention the famous Torias Teleon sometime. Was the video informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and I wish you all an awesome day. The Emperor protects.